Hello, it's Ilja, and I hope you all are having a wonderful day. Today I will do the reader's problems tag, and I was tagged by Elizabeth at Bookish North, and I will of course leave links to both her and the creator in the info box. And Elizabeth, thank you so much for tagging me. The first question is, you have 20,000 books on your TBR. How in the world do you decide what to read next? I am a mood reader, and sometimes I'm craving like a certain book, sometimes I'm craving a certain genre or an author, and then I just follow that craving. Sometimes I'm just browsing through my shelves and picking up books on random, and yeah, that is usually what I'm doing. Number two, you're halfway through a book and you're just not loving it. Do you quit or are you committed? I am somewhat committed, I think. I am not very good at quitting books. So what I will be doing is stick to the book, but at the same time, pick up another book to read as well. Number three, the end of the year is coming and you're so close, but so far away on a Goodreads reading challenge. Do you try to catch up and how? And I try not to think that much about the reading challenge, but at the same time, I know I'm still doing that. So in November and December, I tend to read more shorter books and poetry and books like that. Number four, the covers of a series you love do not match. How do you cope? And I don't buy a lot of series, but I am pretty sure that I would be rather annoyed by that. Another thing with covers that really bugs me is when I'm ordering a book online and I'm ordering a certain cover, and then I get something completely different in the mail. For example, I ordered When I Hit You by Mina Kandasamy, and I thought I was getting this cover, but instead I got this. And I think this is one of the most ugliest covers on my shelf. It looks like someone has eaten a lot of letter-shaped things and ketchup and then just vomited all over the book. And I found it to be so, so bad. And I was so disappointed when I opened the box and saw this one. I almost returned it. Number five. Everyone and their mother loves a book you really don't like. Who do you bond with over shared feelings? And even though I really enjoy a good rant with someone that dislikes a book as much as I do, usually I just move on. I mean, we like different things. Number six, you're reading a book and you're about to start crying in public. How do you deal? And I am quite an emotional reader. I tend to tear up quite a bit. I'm not like sobbing or anything, but yeah, I tear up easily. And also, I really enjoy reading in public, so this happens all the time. And usually, I just let it happen. Number seven, a sequel or book you loved just came out, but you've forgotten a lot about the prior novel. Will you reread the book, skip the sequel, try to find a synopsis on Goodreads, or cry in frustration? And I will either reread the book, or maybe just the last chapters, or I will just dive into the other book and hope for the best. Number eight, you do not want anyone borrowing your books. How do you politely tell people nope when they ask? And I lend out my books, and usually I get them back as well. Number nine, reading ADD. You picked up and put down 5 books in the last month. How do you get over your reading slump? For me, I think the best thing to do is to reread an old favorite. Number 10, there are so many new books coming out that you're dying to read. How many do you actually buy? And even though I do buy a lot of books and I'm enjoying buying a lot of books, I don't tend to buy a lot of new releases, so I don't think there will be that many books. Number 11, after you bought the new books you can't wait to get to, how long do they sit on your shelf before you get to them? Well, some books are staying on my shelves for years, and some books I will be reading immediately. So that depends. But I am not one that gets stressed out with a large TBR, and I know that I will be reading all of them at some point, and I'm looking forward to read all of them at some point. And that was my take on the reader problems tag. Thank you, Elizabeth, for tagging me. And now I would like to tag someone myself. I would like to tag Jamie from Jamie Reads, Angelica, Lucifer from Argyle Dinosaur, Juan from Bookish Islander, Angie from Literary Labors, Amy from The Dusty Bookshelf, and Frede from Frede Reads. And if you have already done it, that's okay, but if you haven't, I hope you will do it. I would love to see your answers. And yeah, that was all from me today. Thank you so, so much for watching, and until next time, ha det!